Fukushima man. I should call myself Fukushima man. Fukushima man. This is the original logo. It's still the you see the M there. The M. It's Fukushima, not Fukushima. So anyway, Fukushima, Fukushima man. I came across. I'm gonna let you listen to this. This is an RT broadcast, Russia Today broadcast. And I'd like you to listen to what they're saying. Have a listen.
From our LA studio. Thanks so much, Ramon.
Hey, thanks for having me, Abby.
So, Ramon, before we even get into the sequestration stuff, let's talk about this nuclear site. 2 days ago, I extensively covered the aspects of the site, but give us a sense of how bad
Hanford.
This really is, because I don't think the corporate media is really touching upon the extent of it.
Sure. Well, I gave the Department of Energy a call earlier today. They've yet to respond. But what we do know, as you mentioned in the intro, there are six large tanks that are full of radioactive sludge are leaking right now. Now, last week we got the word that there were six tanks. The week before that, the DOE was only saying that it was one tank. So there's some people wondering if there's more tanks leaking than the Department of Energy has revealed so far. What they have said is that up to 300 million gallons of...
Did you get that? 300 million gallons of...
Radioactive sludge may eventually...
300 million gallons of radioactive sludge. Okay, here's an alert. Keep listening to Ramon.
Leak out of just one of these tanks.
One
and we
tank.
Have to remember that Hanford Reservation, there are 50 million gallons of nuclear...
50 million gallons? Let's keep listening. It's getting more interesting.
Waste throughout the facility. So there's still a lot of concern that some of this nuclear waste is going to be getting into the soil and eventually back into the Columbia River, which has unfortunately suffered quite a bit of pollution from the Hanford site.
Unbelievable. And also that the bins to hold this nuclear toxic waste, they expire in 20 years. I mean, we're talking about waste that does not decompose for millennia. I mean, we cannot get rid of this, so it's just absolutely insane to think of them storing it in these bins that expire. Ramon, let's talk about how much this costs. I mean, $115 billion price tag, of course, we know that's probably the lowest estimate.
What she's saying is that the bins are going to expire. Their natural shelf life is 20 years, while the shit they carry inside is hundreds, thousands of years. And nobody is really paying attention. And it's, oh, geez, in 20 years, it'll all leak out. 50 million gallons of radioactive sludge in one nuclear facility. Not all of America, all of the country. In one out of how many plants do they have? 140, 150 plants in the U.S.? Maybe more, 200? I don't know. Anyway, let's listen some more. What do these smart newscasters have?
Possible. Until the year 2090, of course, it's probably way more than that. I mean, let's talk about the sequester, though, and how this could affect this cleanup effort.
Right. I mean, well, the governor of Washington has called this the perfect radioactive storm, and it really is.
When she said sequester, it has to do with the fact that the fiscal cliff, all the financial woes, whatever the place is going through down there, they're going to start cutting funds about taking care of this nuclear waste that's going to spill out into the rivers. And the nuclear Armageddon is unfolding as we speak, with millions and millions of gallons of this brutal stuff about to leak into the environment. And at least RTV is presenting something. Let's listen some more.
When you take into consideration that just at the same time that we're hearing that these tanks are leaking sludge, there's a possibility that the Department of Energy, will have to furlough some of the workers that have been working at the Hanford Reservation
furlough.
In order to clean this thing up.
Layoffs,
as you mentioned, the
unemployment.
Department of Energy is estimating that this project to clean up the site will cost something along the lines of $115 billion till the year 2090, but that price tag could go up very easily. I mean, the price tag to build the plant to turn some of this sludge into a more manageable substance has already gone over $13 billion the budget, and it's way behind schedule, and costs continue to rise, which has really caused a lot of concern among Congress that are starting to question what it is that we're throwing that money at.
$115 billion to clean up one plant, and that is a low estimate, as this Ramon newscaster is reporting on RT. $115 billion, one plant. Multiply that by 100, and you have something trillion. Times 10 is trillion. Quadrillion. We're looking at quadrillion. It's a number I can't even conceive. It's got from here to me walking home, if everything was a bunch of zeros, it makes no sense whatsoever. $115 billion to clean up a plant, and they say nuclear energy is the most inexpensive clean energy. Well, if you eliminate the toxic sludge, if you eliminate the decommissioning, which cost $115 billion, conservatively speaking, nuclear energy becomes the nightmare of all nightmares, because number one, it's not clean, number two, it's not inexpensive, and number three, some fat cats are filling their pockets and the planet is dying. We are in intensive care. Helen Caldicott has said, Kevin Blanch has said, people are out there warning us and nobody's paying attention. So in the background, you've got, I've put up, this is just a byproduct. It's the salute. Yeah, salute. Salute by the astronaut. Salute. Yeah, goodbye. Up yours. This is the salute. This is the salute we got from the moon. Do you want to hear a little bit more? Is there some more here?
Absolutely. And I think the thing that's most irritating to me, Ramon, is hearing them talk about this $85 billion cut as if it's the most serious thing in the world. Really a total drop in the bucket when you're looking at our $1 trillion deficit in this country. We're hearing from everyone, these defense cuts are going to be a dupe.
Okay, now she's going to go into defense cuts. Who gives a shit about the defense cuts? Yeah, right. Whatever the situation is there. My point, I am just putting this out for someone. RT TV on February 27th, put this out for the public. It's out there, people, it's out there. It's not me ranting, it's not some art flake ranting, some leukemia patient ranting down in Utah, or a medical doctor, Caldicott, ranting and telling us things. This is coming out now on a major news network, the RT network, and talking about the truth, the real nature of this monster. $115 billion conservatively cleanup for a site that is now potentially leaking 50 million gallons of sludge, radioactive sludge going in the environment on one plant. Oh, I rest my case. If anybody hasn't understood this yet, and I talk to people and they just sort of try to walk away from it, but there is no walking away from this anymore, because it's real and it's brutal. It's ugly.